Network troubleshooting using Wireshark.
Today, what we're going to be covering is how to listen to voice conversations via RTP in Wireshark. So this is a very short subject. It's actually very easy to do. The most difficult part of this is actually getting the capture in the first place to be able to listen to. So we're going to spend a little bit of time on that, and then we're going to go into Wireshark and show you how to do it. Before we get into that, full disclaimer, this video is for educational purposes, with the assumption that you have authorization to listen to the conversations in question. If it is part of your work as an analyst or an engineer, if this is an unauthorized capture of traffic, obviously we do not support that, and you should cease and desist. So that being said, let's look at the scenario. This diagram may look a little bit complicated, but I'll explain as we go. So with RTP, or the real-time transport protocol, RTP is the protocol which actually transfers the voice data between two users who are communicating over the protocol. There's also SIP, which is usually paired with RTP. SIP is the protocol which is used for call signaling. So, you know, call setup and all the exchanges that need to happen in order to do that. But RTP is what actually carries the data. Now, in a very simplistic case, say you have a PC over here with a headset and a PC over here with a headset, and they want to have a voice conversation. The RTP conversation or the RTP data would be exchanged from this PC through the router over the internet to this router and then to this PC. Okay, so there's a lot more to it than that with respect to NATing and other concepts. But if, for example, all you wanted to do was capture that conversation, you could capture it from this PC using Wireshark or TCP dump. You could also do it from this PC, and then you would get that conversation in full. Now, if this PC was having a conversation with this PC and you captured here, you would not get that conversation because those packets are not traversing the router and going to you. They're going down to this PC over here. If, in fact, you wanted to capture all the voice traffic from this network on this on the right to this traffic network on the left, you would capture from the router. So this capture point would actually change and go here. And that would capture all traffic in and out of this network to the internet, including hopefully the voice traffic you're looking for. Now, there is a flavor of RTP where because of the way the internet works and IP addressing works and NATs, the traffic itself does not go directly from router to router, or specifically not directly from PC to PC. You have something known as a session border controller that is involved. And the session border controller has many functions, which we're not going to cover. But in short, in these scenarios, the session border controller acts as a man in the middle to the voice conversation and to the SIP conversation as well. So in that scenario, the flow looks a little bit like this. The traffic for voice actually goes through the SBC and either directly from the SBC to the router to the PC, or if the SBC is inside the network, it might do something like this, right? Really what you need to know is the SBC in these cases is going to be the man in the middle to all phone calls for phones that are registered to the SBC. So in that case, and say this is an enterprise scenario, if you wanted to capture all voice traffic for all calls, you would do that at the SBC. Now you'd have to look at what interface on the SBC is used for the voice traffic. Sometimes SBCs have multiple interfaces. But that would be your capture point. That would capture all voice traffic. Okay. So with that being said, let's get to Wireshark. All right. I have my sample capture open here in Wireshark. This capture was taken from the repository at wireshark.org. I'll post the link in the notes, but it is a sample capture of SIP traffic. Now, the first thing we want to do when we have a capture like this, if it is not filtered at the capture point, meaning if it's not filtered to just SIP, which this one is not, you can see there's SNMP traffic and some other traffic. You want to go to telephony, RTP, and then RTP streams. What this window will show you is all of the RTP streams that are present within this capture file. And what you need to do is associate the two streams which represent the forward conversation and the reverse conversation, meaning each of the streams, meaning the data streams, will be separate. So if I'm talking to you, my traffic from my PC to yours is one stream, and your traffic from your PC to mine is another stream. The way you associate the two, say that you had multiple conversations in this file, would be based on the ports. So in this case, the tuple of source port and destination port should be identical on both streams, just reversed. So here you can see it's 40376 to 8000, and then in the other conversation down here, it's 8000 to 40376. So once you identified that, it's really simple. You just go down here and play streams. And what you'll see is this window here. Now, what Wireshark is doing is overlaying the forward stream with the reverse stream, and it will allow you to play the two together. And when I do that, it sounds like this.
¿Por colota?
Por el Atlas, obviamente.
Bueno, sí te escucho bien.
Ah, ya ves, eso sí se escuchó.
05 1454 0005. Y ahí oigo el tutut. Pero bueno, ahí tú me estás escuchando, Juan.
Sí, yo te escucho. ¿Cuál estamos probando?
And that's it. You're able to listen to the conversation in full in both directions. Now, as I mentioned, if there are more conversations in this list, you need to do a little bit of pattern matching to identify which conversations are which, because say you captured from that SBC that we mentioned earlier, you're going to have dozens, if not hundreds, of conversations that you have to sift through. That's it for this video. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please like and subscribe. Also, if you have an issue that you're working on and you would like to review the capture on the channel or get some advice, feel free to post a link to it below with a description, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Until next time.